only thing actually giving me trouble isn't something I made or built. It's something I bought.
So this is the booster board that I did the battery mod on, and it ended up not really working how I hoped it would, but I know why. I know the exact reasons how to fix this thing, but we're gonna cover that in a future video, because in this video, we're gonna talk about something a little different. I love riding electric vehicles, and in fact, the only thing that's more fun than riding them is riding them with other people. And there's one person who I've always wanted to go on a ride with, but never been able to, and that's my wife, Jenna. I would really like to fix that.
He gives me enough attitude, he could be.
So this is Jenna.
Hi,
we've been
I'm
married
Jenna.
For almost 3 years. She's a nurse. She actually works at a hospital. Feeding patients medicine and drugs.
I feed them drugs, yes.
I work from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m.
So since Jenna is so uncomfortable riding things like skateboards and one wheels, she's okay with riding a bicycle, so an electric bike is the perfect logical way to go. I wanted to do something special just for her. I'm going to build an electric bike for my wife. You know what this is? This is a gasoline-powered motorcycle, and it's really fast, but it has all these complicated parts and machinery that have to work together. If we take that and simplify it down into just an electric system, we can put all of that on this bicycle in very few parts, and I'll show you just how simple it actually is. You only need four primary components to make an electric vehicle like a bike, and you have your power source, a battery of some sort, a throttle, and you have the brains of the operation, the computer chip. It's called a speed controller because that communicates with the motor and makes it spin when you give it an input. Now that I have all of the parts to make an electric bike, I need to figure out some sort of system to actually mount it to the bike itself. This guy named Tom Stanton on YouTube, I think he's an aeronautical engineer, he came up with this brilliant design where he actually 3D printed parts out of PLA plastic and mounted all of his components to his bike using those pieces. However, he's using what's called PLA, which is traditionally a very brittle, unreliable material if you want to make any mechanical parts out of. So I figured I'd reach out to him personally and ask him that question myself. Hey, how's it going, man? Nice to meet you. What made you want to make this bike out of 3D printed parts?
I've been wanting to do it for quite a while, actually.
Like, what made you want to 3D print the parts instead of just going out and buying brackets and, you know, machining parts and doing that instead?
The main thing was cost. I have a 3D printer. I thought, why not just try it?
What makes you think that 3D printed part will be strong enough for the motor to be attached to it?
Even if a material is quite weak, if you design it properly and, you know, add enough material, then it can be strong, really.
Maybe it's a misconception, but people seem to think that 3D printed parts, especially out of PLA plastic, are particularly weak.
Well, from previous experience, I learned quite a lot about the strengths of PLA, and I think it usually gets its brittle tendencies from the way that people print it. When the printer head comes back round, you've got to make sure that it's hot enough so that it melts the layer below it slightly. Yeah, so if you have a cold layer and then a hot layer on top, it doesn't completely fuse. Whereas if the layer below it's still quite warm, then it has a better fuse together and it creates a stronger part.
Okay, okay. The bike literally just arrived, wow.
You better get building then.
Yeah, I guess so. More or less.
Now you should be able to ride it around.
All right, this is the maiden ride on the $200 bike. I chose it because it was really well reviewed and had a bunch of good reviews for some good reviewing. Look at C-Mike over here riding the one wheel. I've now finished 3D printing the parts I need to attach these things to the bicycle, and they are these. This is two halves of a motor mount. This will wrap around one of the poles, and the motor will attach directly to this, which will attach to a belt system attached to the pulley. Now the pulley is interesting. It's not a single object, it's four separate objects that we're gonna glue together, and the reason for that is because the 3D printer I have isn't that large. It's a really cheap printer. It's the Monoprice MP Select Mini. Okay, before we continue, I want to talk about something that might surprise you. This is the battery pack that's going to go on the bicycle, and it's a big battery, so I know what you might be thinking. This is gonna cost a lot to charge. Here in the United States, the average cost of electricity is 12 cents per kilowatt hour. And what is a kilowatt hour? It's an amount of energy. It's not speed, which is a kilowatt. Don't confuse the two. Electricity usage here is measured in kilowatt hours. This right here is a gallon of water. And let's do an analogy, and let's pretend that this is a single kilowatt hour of energy. A typical American home uses about 900 of these a month. This is an iPhone 7. It has a battery of about 0.007 kilowatt hours, which is equivalent to 2 tablespoons from this gallon. What that means is that I can charge this phone 10 times before I've even paid a single penny. This is my one wheel, and it has a battery capacity of 0.13 kilowatt hours, which is equivalent to an eighth of a gallon, otherwise known as a pint. This would actually cost 2 cents to power the one wheel, just 2 pennies. I've gone over 1,500 miles on it, which is equivalent to about $5 worth of energy. I can go halfway across America for only $5 on the one wheel. I wanna make one final comparison, and that's comparing my gasoline car to a Tesla Model S, which has an 85 kilowatt hour battery, which takes about $10 to charge from 0 to 100%. Compare that to this car, which runs off of gasoline, which goes the same distance, costs $45. But if you compare that to the bike, it only takes $1 to go the same distance. So how much is it gonna cost to charge this bicycle? Well, the battery is about half a kilowatt hour, so half a gallon is about 5 cents, or a nickel. Imagine charging this thing to go 20 miles for a nickel. All right, I just wanted to get that out of the way because I think it's really cool. Let's get back to the build.
First things first though, I have to make sure that the speed controller can work with the motor, and I've already got a problem. The issue here is that the bullet connectors don't fit. I have to solder something else in here.
I've got the bullet connectors soldered inside the larger bullet connectors, and I put some shrink wrap on and then covered up the exposed metal bits with some liquid tape. And now what's beautiful about this is that the motor connects to the speed controller. So now the next step is to actually plug the speed controller into my computer so that I can test the motor. Start detection. It works! It works! This is a 12-tooth pulley, and this is what attaches to the motor to actually drive the belt which powers the bike. The problem is that the little hole here is a little too small to go around the shaft of the motor, so I have to take a bigger drill bit and bore this out. For that, we need a drill press. Oh no.
Well, we'll see
yeah,
if
it's off.
Do you want to try it?
It's just gonna wobble. Now I'm gonna try and see if it works.
You almost hit yourself in the face.
It's going backwards. Great thing about electric motors, if the motor's going backwards, you literally just unplug 2 of the little 3 cables and switch them. So now if I switch these 2 cables.
Any 2 cables.
Now it should. Now it's going the right way. So cool. Dude, it works.
It's alive! Alive!
So cool. Oh no. My issue now is that this little metal pulley that I've put onto the motor slips. This little metal thing that we had to drill a hole into. The motor should move with the wheel. One would not move without the other, and yet if I hold the wheel tight, I've got 2 set screws into it, but they're not holding it solid. I was kind of hoping to not use super glue, but that would fix it. The only thing actually giving me trouble isn't something I made or built, it's something I bought. What can I do about this? I think I can just add solder?
To kind of melt these two together? Is that what you're saying?
The issue there is one is steel and one is aluminum. I can't just like solder them together, that's not gonna work. But that solder could break and then not work. But for now it works. I'm gonna go try it. Well, that idea didn't work. So right now, when the motor moves, like...
I was gonna say, I don't know what all the parts are. So is this the motor?
Yeah, so okay. This is the motor, and it's hooked up to the wheel like this. So when the motor moves, the wheel will move.
Okay.
But right now, the issue is that...
The motor moves, the wheel doesn't move.
All the electronics, the motor, even all the 3D printed parts, they all work just fine. It's the aluminum thing here that's attached to the belt.
Is it fixable?
It's replaceable.
I expect better from you.
There's one more step I gotta do, but I think it works.
Well, that was pretty fast. Holy shit.
Hey, get on. Check it out.
I need to put shoes on. You just broke it!
I straight up actually just broke it.
You broke the new pulley.
Are you kidding me?
What?
Yeah!
Are you serious?
It's because I let up on the throttle. And so it caught, causing this whole thing to rotate, and then it caught this pulley right here.
Oh, the spoke is broken.
It's like carbon fiber. When you crack it, it loses all structural integrity.
This is the opposite of carbon fiber, actually. Don't listen to this fake news.
I heard the noise.
Carbon fiber spokes, man. You would have been fine.
It was literally, you were just rolling down the street and it looked
it's
fine.
It's because I let up on the throttle. Why is it wobbling? Why is it wobbling?
The wheel's wobbling.
I see that!
The Wright brothers, their first plane, well, actually it was pretty good, but no, I'm just
kidding. How'd you feel it, Brandon?
I expect better from you.
Okay, what is wrong and how do I fix this? Some spokes are broken, but it still works. The bent pulley, yeah, that should be fine. The motor is okay, I just need to put it back into place. I need to be able to coast along, but the motor's not letting me. It makes me think that there's probably some sort of regenerative braking setting that I completely overlooked. If I can fix that, then...
Oh god, there's a car.
Alright, I think I can handle that.
That wouldn't work last time.
It would just stop. Yeah.
And there's one person who I've always wanted to go on a ride with, but never been able to, and that's my wife, Jenna. I would really like to fix that.
How do you feel? What's this like?
It's amazing! Come on, faster! I just wanted to show you that I'm back.
I survived.
It's really easy. I was a little bit worried. It's so fast. Faster than the one wheel.
Yeah.
It's amazing. I'm so excited. It's much better than the one wheel. I feel like I can actually ride it places rather than be like, I'll be there in like 5 years because I'm going so slow.
I'm okay with this.
So speedy.
That was quite the learning experience. As you can probably tell, I didn't really know what I was doing, so I'm really happy I was able to figure this out. And thank you for sticking through this learning experience. Big thanks to Tom Stanton for helping me with this project. This project was a lot of fun. I hope to do another video like this, but I don't know what to build. So leave a comment below telling me what to do next. I'm gas because this thing is expensive. Oh. I don't have my keys on me! Shut up!